What's up, my fellow FIFA hooligans? Thank you so much for watching another video. Today I wanted to cover what exactly is this new training and development process that has been completely revamped from the previous FIFAs. So I wanted to start off with the training schedule, and in this particular case you can assign either through the calendar a specific schedule for the entire month, and this will actually follow for the entire season. You can change things from having rest days before matches and recovery after, having intermittent training, or having training throughout the entire week. So this is one option. The other option is to switch over to the weekly schedule, in which case you can actually edit day by day and change specific sessions depending on player morale, fitness, or even their sharpness. So the higher rated sharpness, the better they will progress as far as their development plans. And obviously the lower, once you get below about 50, they could actually either stifle progression in different attributes, or they could actually start declining. For the training itself, you can now do up to 15 players each day. The difference is this doesn't actually improve any of their attributes. This only affects their fitness, their sharpness, and their morale, all of which are important, but they won't directly affect any of their development. Which makes sense, because now you really only have to play this one time in that particular save, and you can simulate the rest. So in this case, if I got a B in the time-logged through pass, it will take that grade and apply it to any future simulation. And if you don't play any of them and you just simulate, you will get a minimum D rating. I still recommend playing them at least once, and you can check out my playlist on how to get an A grade on some of the training sessions. Now let's move on to development, and this is the part that's very interesting, and it's also the most different from any other FIFA we've had before. You can't directly impact specific attributes. So what they did is they give you a different style of growth for every player. So here in the goalkeeper, you'll notice that I can either do a balanced approach, in which case every attribute will get growth. I also have the option of specific growth under, for example, a goalkeeper option or a sweeper keeper style of play, which is great because this allows you to fully customize, if you will, the player to fit your specific squad. And you'll notice, depending on which option you choose, the ATA that it will take for that player to develop will change. So if I go to a goalkeeper or a sweeper keeper, since it's a focused training, it will only take them 4 weeks in order to reach the next level up, in his case a 61. Now you'll notice this applies to every position, and depending on the style of play that that player is going to be developed in will affect which attributes are improved. The other interesting part of this is that you can actually change a player's position, and that also takes a certain amount of time. So in this case, you can see that my center mid, I have an option to change him into any position, and he can develop at different rates. So in the top left there, you'll see the amount of weeks that it'll take for him to transition from a center mid to a left mid or center forward, etc. So here for Tejas, what I wanted to do was develop certain attributes more, and since he's already an 84, I really wanted to focus on defensive awareness, his standing tackle, and his strength. So I ended up choosing a defensive wide back because it accelerated the growth in those fields that I was specifically looking for. So now it went from 13 weeks for him to reach 85 down to 4 weeks, and that's because I specifically chose the development plan. So if we just move forward here, you'll see that now he is an 85. This is 4 weeks later, and you can either continue the development plan that you're on, or you can change it up. But that's really all I have. Thank y'all for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below.